Father, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
We have gathered this morning to celebrate the life and the legacy of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. We pay tribute to the dream, his vision, his leadership, his sacrifice, the dedication in helping our country to live up to its creed. Dr. King sought social justice and equality for all. It is indeed a known fact that Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was a dreamer. And how many of you know that dreams do come true? If I might pose a question this morning, I would like to ask you, do I have any dreamers in the house? I am a witness that dreams do come true, because it is on this very stage where I stand and I begin to perform my stage plays here at the Landis Junior High School Auditorium. God has blessed me to travel all over the country and to perform on some of the same stages, some of the same theaters that Tyler Perry has performed in. I know dreams come true. Dreams. We must pursue the dream no matter how far-fetched it may seem. For your dreams are like your children. They are your offspring. Dreams are the joy of the present and your hope for the future. Don't let somebody else's disapproval or jealousy of your dream hinder your dream. Dreams must overcome opposition to be realized. I'm reminded this morning of a basketball superstar, Michael Jordan's dream. Even though he was cut from his high school basketball team, he didn't give up. Amen. He had this philosophy, and I quote, "I play to win. The day I stop improving is the day I walk away from the game," unquote. Yeah. Dr. King faced many oppositions. Even in his nonviolent and his peaceful marches and movements, he encountered extreme violent acts, but he kept on marching and he kept on dreaming. I ask you this morning, are you willing, my brothers and sisters, to pay the price for your dreams? Even dreams come with a price, for it was the children of Israel that had a dream of living in the promised land, but find themselves wandering in the wilderness. Another question we must ask of ourselves this morning, does my dream benefit others? Another aspect of a dream is that it's never progress until it's pursued. You must seek it in order to obtain it. You must apply effort and energy into it, and you must follow through. If you don't follow through on it, sometimes your dream might just be merely a nightmare. Another aspect I found out about dreams is that dreams take time. How do you know that delayed don't mean denied? Can I be witnessed? For Dr. King waited 10 long years to see his dream come true with the passing of the Voting Rights Act in 1965. Years prior to that, years were filled with threats and hardships with the civil rights movement. Dreamers must be faithful no matter how others act. Dreamers will encounter hatred. Don't you think everybody's going to be happy because you got a dream? How many of us know anything about Joseph? And Joseph, the dreamer, told his brothers about what was going on. They conspired to kill him. Dreamers will encounter hatred. Dr. King is a great example in that he reminds all of us here today that you may not be able to control how one treats you, but we can control how we react to the treatment. You must not stop dreaming, people. What dreams have you given up today? What dreams have you let someone talk you out of today? Secondly, dare. The motto of the British SAS regiment is, who dares wins. As a youngster, I remember being confronted on the schoolyard, and back then they would stick a little stick on your shoulder, yes, and then dare you to somebody to knock that off of your shoe. Anybody know what I'm talking about? I remember one day I was bold enough to knock that stick off of a classmate's shoulder, and oh, and then the fight began. See, back in the day, we fought with our fists.
We fought
from our fists to this.
Yeah.
Oh, with how times have changed. And I've always been one for a good fight, and here I stand today still fighting, but I'm fighting the good fight. What is the good fight? I'm glad that you asked me this morning. The good fight is fighting for the right, fighting against social pressures and prejudices, daring others to do better and to be better. I dare you this morning to keep fighting until folk will see you for who you really are. You are somebody up in here, because I'm reminded this morning that God don't make no jokes. I dare you to keep fighting until other folks will see the difference, till other folks will stop looking so much at your outside and seeing what's on your inside, because you are more than just what meets the eye. I dare you to go back to your homes and to your street corners and your neighborhoods, for there's some reclaiming that needs to be done this morning. We've got to reclaim our hamlets and our villages. I heard someone say that it takes a village to raise a child. But I'm here to tell you today, it still takes a village to raise a child.
Yes,
I heard somebody say that the villages were sick. But I've got a remedy for that this morning, and it's found in 2 Chronicles 7 and 14, which says, if my people who are called by my name will humble until all the senseless shooting and killing of our young people have stopped, we must be more concerned about revelation rather than retaliation. And last, but certainly not least this morning, we must get off of our seats of do nothing, our seats of passiveness and complacency. We can no longer just sit on the premises. We've got to stand on God's promise. We've got to go back, and we've got to really learn that old Negro national anthem that says, lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. We've got to learn so that not only do we know every word, but we know every verse, we know every stanza. We've got to teach it to ourselves and teach it to our children. We got work to do. The march is not over yet. We still got some Trayvon Martins to save. We still got some injustices that we've got to deal with. We got to practice what we preach. We are living in a time where we just can't be talking about it. We got to be about it. Yes, the dreamer is gone, but the dream still lives on. And I'm reminded that Dr. King has passed that now to you and to you and to you. It's up to us to keep the dream alive. Dream, dare, do. Do, dare, dream. Any way you put it, it's got some validity to it. But you got to dream. Where are my dreamers at in here today? You got to focus and back to reclaim your sweet boy.
my God, of that old Negro spirit. Oh, that says my eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. He's trampling out the vengeance where the grapes of wrath are stored. I can read his righteous sentence by the dimming flaring lamps. His day is marching on. I've seen him in the watchtower of 100 circling cats. They have built him an altar in the evening dews and days. I can read his righteous sentence by the dimming flaring lamps. His truth is marching on in the beauty of the lily. Christ was born across the sea where the glory is mother that transfigured human being as he died to make me holy. Yes, he lived to make me holy. Our God is marching on. I want to close with saying glory.
Want it off?